Hey YouTube, today I'm going to show you how to play the acoustic version of Fix You by Coldplay. Right, I'm going to forget to mention it. Basically, my friends and I have done a cover of it. It will be somewhere down the right-hand side of your screen. That side. So, you know, please watch it, please comment, please rate, please subscribe. I do do requests, you know, for tutorials, not for singing. You know, for tutorials, blah-de-blah-de-blah. I couldn't be asked to put my contacts in today, so I'm sorry, YouTube. You're seeing my lovely little glasses. Anyway, so, on to Coldplay. Basically, if you want to play along with CD, you need a capo on three. Now, you put the capo wherever it suits your voice. So don't ask me where you put the capo because I don't know. Okay, so for this song, you'll need like five chords, I think it is. You'll need C, C major 7, A minor, G, F, and G sus. Okay, so if you know how to play them, skip ahead. If you don't, keep watching. High E string. String 1, low E string, string 6. Okay, C, you put your middle finger on the second string, first fret. Your middle finger on the fourth string, second fret. And your ring finger on the fifth string, third fret. C major 7, this is an amazing chord. Basically, you just take your top finger off. And voila, we have C major 7. Okay, A minor, you put your first finger on the second string, first fret, your middle finger on the fourth string, second fret, and your ring finger on the third string, second fret. G, you put your first finger on the fifth string, second fret, your ring finger on the sixth string, third fret. I'm sorry, that was your middle finger even, because it's your finger in the middle, anyway, on the sixth string, first fret. Oh my god, I give up. On the 6th string, 3rd fret, then you put your ring finger on the 2nd string, 3rd fret, and your ring finger on the 1st string, 3rd fret. Okay, F. There's like a little bar chord way of playing this. Well, anyway, I can't really do it, but so I'm going to teach you how to play it this way, and I recommend you play it this way in the song because it makes the chord changes a hell of a lot easier. Okay, so F. You bar the 1st string, you bar the first and second strings at the first fret with your first finger. You put your middle finger on the third string, second fret, and your ring finger on the fourth string, third fret. Last chord now, G sus. First finger on the second string, first fret, middle finger on the fifth string, second fret, and ring finger on the third fret, sixth string. Sounds a bit random, but whatever, we'll get onto that. Okay, chords done. Okay, there are two chord patterns to learn this song. There's a chord pattern for the introduction and the verse, and this is exactly the same, and then the chord pattern for the chorus, but I'll talk about the chorus chord pattern later, because it doesn't have a rhythm, you just have to fit the chords in with the words, which is cool, but whatever. Okay, so the chord pattern for the verse and the introduction, C, C major 7, A minor, and G. So each of those is held for four beats. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 3, 4, 4, 2, 3, 4. Like I just did there. Four beats, four chords, 16 beats in total. Yay me. Anyway, okay, so maybe you can basically play those introduction chords, you know, maybe once or twice. You can play them three times. You can play that pattern three times for an introduction, but if you think about it, it might be a bit boring. But whatever, it's your cover, do what you want. Okay, so I'm quickly just going to show you where those chords fit in with the words, and I'll make up a little strumming pattern. If it's all right, I'll talk about that strumming pattern. Anyway, so basically, this ain't a singing lesson, I ain't a singer, whatever. Then you have another verse. Okay, I'm sorry, I kind of mucked up the little strumming bit there, so I'll make up a little strumming rhythm and talk about that later. Anyway, so if... No, I'll talk about it now, in fact. So basically, if you want to jazz the song up a bit more, make it a bit more lively, you could do a... When you try your best, but you don't succeed. and that is down, down, up, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, up. Or one, two, and four, and one, two, and four, and up on the ands. Or you can just do a which is probably, you know, a bit more, not as lively and probably more suitable to the song. So that's down, 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 up, down. So down, 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 up, down, 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 up, down, 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 up, down, down. I'll write these out in boxes underneath. Okay, so I think I'm losing my voice. Great, I'm going to be ill again. Viral plague, in fact. Anyway, so on to the back to the song. So the chorus sounds a little like this. I'm sorry, this chorus is kind of hard to sing, so I'm probably going to muck it up, but you know, whatever. Lights will guide you home and ignite your bones, and I will try to fix you. I thought the singing was alright then, but the guitar playing was very questionable. Anyways, so the chord pattern for the chorus is F, C, then G sus. And that repeats twice, and then it changes to C, G sus, and C. So that was, you have an F before lights, and then on will, C, G sus, on guide, you an F on home, and then C on the ig of ignite, G sus on the night of ignite, your then F on bones, and I C will G sus try to fix C U. And that's cool, you know, you can kind of hear it. Anyway, so picking. Yeah, basically I made the picking up, but I think it sounds cool, so I'll teach you how to do that. Okay, C. Okay, high E string, string one, low E string, string six. C, what you do is you pluck the second string and the fifth string together, then you hit string 3, 4, 3, and the 3, 4, 3 stays the same whichever chord you hit. The only notes that change are the first two notes you pluck. So C, 2 and 5, 3, 4, 3, C major 7, once again, 2 and 5, 3, 4, 3, A minor, 3, then you pluck string 2 and 4, so 3, 3, 4, 3, and then G, you hit string 2 and 6, 3, 3, 3, 4, 3. So C, 2 and 5, C major 7, 2 and 5, A minor 2 and 4, 3, 4, 3, and then G, 2 and 6, 3, 4, 3. Okay, so, you know, that's cool, that's done. You know, please comment, please rate, please subscribe. I do requests, so, you know, send me any questions you have, and this tutorial probably hasn't been amazing, but, you know, whatever, life goes on, as long as you get the vague sense of the chords you need. That's cool, you know, my job's done. Anyways, you know, have a nice life, please comment, please rate, please subscribe, blah, de blah, de blah.